Dear the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, what I mean, أولا كل سنة طيبين جميعا. Today actually the last Sunday of the Coptic year. And Tuesday night we'll have the celebration of the eve of the Coptic year, and Wednesday will be the new Coptic year. And if you noticed the reading of the today, similar to last week, because last week was the last week of the last Sunday of the blessed month of Misra. And also today, the first week of the month of Al-Mansi, the day that's forgotten. And today's reading is similar to last week. If you noted the theme about one thing only, the end of life. End of life. One day everything will end. And the story happened actually, we'll feed it last week, we read it from Mark chapter 13. And today we read the same story, or the same gospel from Matthew 24. Our Lord God Jesus Christ, it seemed like he was in the altar, and he walked out of the altar, sat on the Mount of Olive tree, and then some of the disciples came to him and asked him, do you see this beautiful building here? It seemed like the altar was very beautiful, magnificent, very beautiful. And it seemed like one of the meditation here said people were caring so much about the outside looks, but the key words inside. For the Lord God actually prophesied and said, by the way, this altar must be destroyed. For when they discover that the Lord knew the future, they ask him the most important question all of us will have to know, what will be the end of life? Tell us, what will be the end of life? And when you go home, I want to actually to read Mark chapter 13 and Matthew chapter 24, we'll read it to the end. And he started actually listing, I put it here in points, 6 points. Number one, he said, what will happen to the world? What will happen? There will be a war, will be an earthquake, will be hunger and famine in many different places. A nation will rise against nation. Number two, actually, he spoke about what will happen to the believer. How the believer will be persecuted, will be actually discriminated. And even a father can discriminate his own daughter or his son. And we have seen this actually in the early church when the gospel started spread. We see how actually Saint Damiana, his father, was basically actually almost willing to put her to death. And number three actually spoke about the destruction of Jerusalem. And this prophecy actually already completed in the year 70 AD when one of the emperors actually entered into Jerusalem and he destroyed Jerusalem. Then after that, actually, he spoke also, number four, he spoke about, he said, the gospel will be preached to the whole world. Number five, actually, he said, there will be actually false prophets and false teaching. And in the end, he said, then the Son of Man will be coming in his glory and will come from, he will send his angels to the four corners of the elect and will gather the elect one. But after, actually, he spoke about the end of life here, the sign of the end of life, He gave us three advices and three spiritual rules. The first advice actually said, you know, by the way, heaven and earth will go away, but my word will not go away, which means the first advice, what you hear is true. It's a confirmation the word of God will never be away. Therefore, actually, if you notice the most dilemma, a struggle we always hear about the end of life. So many books written, don't believe anything. Just stick to the word of God and believe in the Bible. You remember during the millennium, everybody said, that's it. The millennium will be the end of life. And what happened? And many different. Matter of fact, they always say so many books written about the end of life. But he said, no, number one, heaven and earth will fall, will go away, but my word will not go away. The second advice I actually give it here, that day and that hour, nobody knows. But therefore, do not be, because the end of life, it could be any day for me when I live this life here. For therefore, that day and that hour, nobody knows. Matter of fact, he put a condition in the parable of the 10 virgin in Matthew 24, verse 13. He said, watch therefore, for you do not know neither the day or the hour when the Son of Man is coming. Nobody knows the hour. Nobody knows the day. We heard so many dilemma about the end of life, but nobody knows. And the third condition, you heard it today, actually, which are very important rules or condition. You will heard it in the 2 Peter chapter 3 during the Catholic Epistle. He said, remember, one day with the Lord equal to 1,000 years. And 1,000 years with the Lord equal to it one day. And all of us actually experienced that. Remember March, I think March 15 or 14, 2020? One day, the whole world was closed completely. If anybody told us before even 1 hour, by the way, guess what? There will be no flying, no the whole world during the time of the pandemic. Nobody would believe that. But 1 hour, one day, it changed the world completely. For therefore, this three rules, he really put it. He said, number one, heaven and earth will go away, but my word will not go away. Number two, no one, let no one deceive you. No one know the hour except and the time. Watch therefore, for you do not know neither the day or the hour with the sun. And the third condition, by the way, remember, and you can see, oh, still there's so many signs here. So can a war, earthquake, can happen in a second. And all of us, we witnessed that during the time of the pandemic, when just one day, it changed the whole world completely. One day, everything was closed. If somebody can come and tell us, by the way, the church will be closed. You cannot go outside of the street. You're going to be staying in your homes. You cannot fly. Tell him, are you, we'll tell him, call 911. This man must be go to, yani, be kharraf, yani. And then he put a three important condition. I call it spiritual rules. And I think all of that's what I want to focus on. These spiritual rules are very important to all of us. Number one, actually, said, take heed, watch and pray. Very simple. Say it with me. Take heed, watch and pray. Take heed, watch and pray. The first rule, actually, in our spiritual rules, make sure take heed. What the word take heed mean? When you look at your dictionary and search for the word take heed, means pay attention or be careful. Be careful. And all of us, actually, forgive me, who are not sometimes paying attention to our spiritual life. Be attention. Sometimes the biggest struggle in our spiritual life for not being attention to the little sin that Satan allowed in our life here. Small problem happen and become big. Pay attention. Or in other words, actually give God your undivided attention. How beautiful all of us gather to give God our undivided attention. And حتى بالعرب لك انظر. Keep always looking. Pay attention. You know exactly, and when you give God your undivided attention, God will be with you and support you. You remember, I actually take him to my mind right now. One of the beautiful turning points in the life of Moses. Moses actually lived 40 years in Egypt. Then after he killed the Egyptian, he ran for his life. Then he spent another 40 years in Horeb. Then the Lord God actually appeared to him on an amazing sight. He was walking after 40, almost 80 years old, and saw an amazing sight. The burning bush. He saw a bush is burning but not consumed. He was so amazed. But the turning point in the life of Moses, by the way, and this actually it's a beautiful sight here. The, when you read, when you go back home, you'll find it, you read the Bible mentioned actually, he actually turned aside and he paid attention. All of us, we need to turn aside to pay attention to our God. When he gave God his undivided attention, the Lord revealed to him the mystery of the burning bush. And he told him what will happen. The mystery of the burning bush is the symbol of the Virgin Mother, how she carried the divine nature of Christ. So when you give, number one, the first rule basically, take heed means give God your undivided attention. Important rules in spiritual life, be careful. Give God your undivided attention, your divine life. Be careful. Number two actually said, watch. Watch or being watchful. This is somebody saying, be careful, be watchful. Be watchful here means basically, remember, it's spiritual struggle. You must struggle in spiritual life. You have to be watchful. You have to be careful for any little sin. And the third rule actually here, put it, he said, pray. Take heed, watch, and pray. Take heed, pay attention. Watchful being, remember, the biggest rule of spiritual life is one thing, a struggle, spiritual, be watchful, be careful. And number three actually said pray. Pray, which means what? Establish a relationship with the Lord. That's it. Establishing, yani the church gave the book of Ishmael to help us how to pray. We need all of us really to pray. Man ought to pray and to not to lose hope. We need to pray. Prayer will help you actually to discover who God is. There's a beautiful saying about prayer. It said, the one who pray is a true theologian. A true theologian is the one who pray. You want to become a theologian? You want to understand who God is? Just very simple. Just pray. Don't waste a lot of time studying too much about God. But pray and build a relationship with the Lord, you will discover who God is. Who God is. Prayer will help you to build the boundary with itself. Prayer will enlighten your heart. Prayer will help you to have a good relationship with the Lord. For very simple three rules today to our spiritual life. Take heed, be careful. Watch, which means remember, a spiritual life is a struggle. You have to fight the good fight and you have to come back to it. And the most important thing is basically pray, pray, pray. Prayer will open your heart, will enlighten your heart. Just يا حبايبي النهارده كنت بتكلم على اني اخر حد في السنه القبطيه ويوم الثلاث بالليل باذن الله هنحتفل بقيه السنه القبطيه ويوم الاربع هيكون اول يوم للسنه الجديده. والسيد المسيح النهارده كان يتكلم كده لما كان هو طالع من الهيكل وقعد على جبل الزيتون التلاميذ قالوا له شايف المبنى الجميل ده؟ قال لهم على فكره المبنى ده هيتهد كله. فلما لقوا ان هو بيتنبأ كده قالوا له دينا طب علامات نهايه العالم وتكلمنا كده على ست علامات قال لهم ماذا يحدث للعالم امه على امه وبعد كده اتكلم ايه اللي يحدث للمؤمنين نفسهم هيضطهدوا حتى من اهاليهم ما وبعد كده اتكلم على ان هيكون في خراب اورشليم ودي حصلت ديرنج اللي هو تيتوس الملك تيتوس الكينج 1970 وفي نفس الوقت اتكلم على الانجيل لازم يقرص في كل العالم وتكلم بعد كده على ان هيكون في مسيحاء كذبه وانبياء كذبه واخر حاجه قال لهم على فكره مجيء المسيح واعطاهم ثلاث نصايح قال لهم خلي بالكم اوعى ان حد ايه يديسيفيو اول نصيحه قال لهم السماء والارض تزول اما كلمتي لا تزول يعني كلمه ربنا هتمشي وكلمه ربنا اكيده وتاني نصيحه قال لهم على فكره ما تخلوش احد الساعه دي لحظه اللي هو ان يجي اللي هو السيد المسيح دي لا احد يعلم هذه الساعه واخر نصيحه قال لهم على فكره خلي بالكم اتقالت في الكاثوليكيين النهارده قال لهم يوم واحد عند ربنا يساوي 1000 سنه و1000 سنه ايكوال ايه يوم واحد يعني معنى كده انك انت ما تقولش ده لسه العلامات كتيره قوي ومساحه كذبه وانبياء كذبه ومين اللي يتعلم ده ممكن لحظه واحده بس يوم عند ربنا الدنيا كلها تتغير وكلنا شفنا كده ديرنج الوقت لما كانت في كوفيد وحصل اللي هو ايه البلد كلها والعالم كله اتقفل يعني وعطاهم ثلاث نصائح بعد ما عطاهم الثلاث نصائح دول عطاهم ثلاث قواعد اساسيين في حياتنا الروحيه اول قاعده يا احبائي قال لهم انظروا اسهروا صلوا وده اللي احنا محتاجينه في حياتنا الواحد ينظر مين اللي بينظر يقول لهم انظروا كده يا من ايه الواحد اللي بينظر يعني زي الحارس كده لما يكون في حارس تبص ليه ما يقدرش يغمض عينه لو هي واحد جارد كده بيقول لك ما يقدرش لازم يكون ايه عيني ايه على طول مفتوحه ثابت حافظ فقال لهم نمبر 1 انظروا ودي مبدا حلو قوي في حياتي الروحيه وحياتك الروحيه ان الواحد يكون ايه دايما حارس على كل شيء ده ساعات كتير صغير قوي قوي كده ويب سايت صغيره ولا شو صغير خالص يدخل العين يعمل ايه يدنس القلب والفكر والحواس كلها فانظر وخليك ايه بكيرفول الثاني حاجه قال لهم ان انظروا اسهروا السهر هنا معناها تمثل الجهاد الروحي يعني عشان تخلي بالك انظر مهم جدا ولكن عندك يكون جهاد روحي انك تجاهد روح لا يكلل الا الذي يجاهد عشان انا جاهد لازم ايه الحياه الروحيه على فكره صدقوني في الكلمه كلنا بنجاهد كلنا بنجاهد كلنا بنحارب كلنا كل يوم نسقط ونقوم كلنا ان احنا ايه نقوي نكون علاقه مع ربنا وندي فده الحياه الروحيه مبدا اساسي في الحياه الروحيه ان انا جاهد يعني الله ينحي نفسه ابونا بشد ديمتري كنا لما الواحد يروح له في الاتراك كان دايما مشهور بالكلمه بتاعته بتجاهد فده بتجاهد خلاص على كده يبقى انت ايه لا يكهل الذي واخر مبدا قاله السيد المسيح صلوا يبقى انظروا اسهروا ايه وصلوا الصلاه تنور القلب يا احبائي الصلاة على فكره الصلاه الحقيقيه تغير القلب الصلاه تخلي الانسان كده ايه نور للعالم ربنا ادينا هذه الثلاث ارشادات ان احنا ننظر نسهر ونصلي ولهنا كل المجد والكرامه الى الابد